Welcome, Matterporters. Thanks so much for joining me today. In this video, I want to start a series of videos where we'll be taking a very, very in-depth look at all the tools available to you in Workshop. So these are the tools that you're going to be using to customize your 3D tour. In this video particularly, I'm going to be looking at the start location and 3D scans tools. But before we do that, I just wanted to take a step back for a second and look at the toolbar and see all the different features that we'll be covering in this series. So let's go ahead and check this out. We're here on the model page, and in order to access Workshop, I simply click the edit button right here. The model opens up very quickly, and you can see that on the very left at the top, I have the exit button to get out of Workshop, so I can go back to my model page that way. You'll also notice that if I go into one of these tools, that exit button is taken over by the name of the tool itself. So keep that in mind. If you want to exit out of Workshop, you have to deselect or escape from the tool that you're using, and then you'll be able to see the exit button again. To the right, we have the preview button, where I can see all of the changes that I've been making prior to publishing them. Before publishing, none of the changes that I've made are actually publicly visible. So in order to see any of the changes that I do make, I do need to make sure I click that publish button so that my visitors will be able to see those changes. As with Showcase, I also have access to my highlight reel and play button down here, as well as the mesh view, dollhouse view, and floor plan view right there. And in the bottom right corner, I have the settings button available to me right here. And if I click that, my settings will open up. And this is something that you definitely want to keep in mind. Before I get into the tools that we'll cover today, let's take a quick look at the settings. And so first of all, you have the options on the very left over here. Let's start with presentation. If you want your visitors to be able to see all of the information that you have in the details section, then you can choose everything. If you just want them to access a compact view, obviously choose compact. And if you don't want that title in the top left corner to appear at all in your model, just go ahead and select none here. If I go down to tour and highlight reel, this is where I can choose to activate the tour buttons as well as the highlight reel. If you don't have a highlight reel, this is not going to be active no matter what. We'll get to how to edit your highlight reel in another video, but in this case, if you do have a highlight reel and you're wondering why it's not visible, this might be the answer. You want to make sure that this toggle switch is activated. If I go down to the next option, I see units, and this is what allows me to choose the unit of measurement. In this case, I'm going to choose US Imperial, and then I'll go on to advanced. Now in the advanced options, I get to make things like the dollhouse, floor plans, and labels visible to my visitors. If I don't want my visitors to access any one of these options, I just simply toggle the switch to off, but by default, it is going to be on. Also very important to take note of the measurements mode. This being on allows your visitors to see any measurements that you've captured. If you don't want those to be visible to your visitors, then make sure that you turn this toggle switch off. In my case, I'm just going to go ahead and leave on the measurements mode so my visitors are able to see any measurements that I capture, and I'll go ahead and close the settings options. Now let's go ahead and dive right into start location. Now with start location, it's really important to understand that this is where you set the beginning of your guided tour. So in scanning, it usually makes more sense to begin on the lowest floor possible at one of the corners of that floor and start kind of creating a sneaky path of aligned scan positions throughout that floor and then work your way up to the preceding floors. However, of course, when our visitors come to see the model, I don't want them to start at the lowest floor in some random corner. I want them to begin at the entryway. So I'm going to set a start location. So once I've clicked on the start location button, you can see that I have a preview of the start location up here. This is only because this model has already had its start location set. If this is the first time that you are loading this model and coming into the start location, you won't see a preview here. This will just be grayed out. And so you can go anywhere you want. I'll just hit the number 2 to go to the dollhouse view, and I can move around and choose where I want this start location to be. So for example, if I actually want, let's say, the start location to be in the kitchen and not at the front door, then I'll just come over here and hit set. After a second, you can see that the preview just updated. And now anytime I share this model, as soon as that loads, my visitors will be taken right into the kitchen. So that's really all you need to do to set your start location. It's just a matter of activating the tool and clicking the set button. Now, what if I need this model to collaborate with a subcontractor? Or I want to use it to show somebody something very specific. If I'm just a visitor to this model and I have no control over where the visitor begins, but I want to show my partner something that's interesting about this model, how can I send them a link that'll get them to exactly where I need them to be without giving them a whole list of instructions and which way to go? So this is a very important pro tip that I think you'll find very useful. It is the letter U on your keyboard. So regardless of where I am in this model, I'll go over here and I'll choose this as my interest point. I'll hit the letter U and you can see that up comes a link over here. I have the option of using the shortened URL or unchecking that to use the long URL. I recommend just sticking to the short URL. The long one is really, really long. So I'll copy this to the clipboard and I'll go ahead and open up a new incognito window and just hit paste and enter. And you'll see that as soon as the model comes in, it actually loads into the exact location where I was when I hit the U key. So this is a really, really important tool. And it's one of those things that most people don't know about. So I hope you will be able to take advantage of that. So let's go now and get into the 3D scans. I'll just click the 3D scans button here. And let's go over everything that we see now. You can see over here, it says 3D scans, tells us that I'm in the 3D scans tool. You can see I have a list over here. This can be collapsed. And it says floor one over here. Now, if I only have one floor, my visitors aren't going to see the option of choosing what floor they want to isolate. But if I have multiple floors, they will see that. And these are the names that they're going to see in that list. So right now it would say floor one. In order to rename that, I just come over here to this three-dot menu, tap there and hit rename. I can also click up here on the gray bar to collapse the list or expand the list. Now this list is reflected in the numbers on the floor as well. You can see as soon as I went into this tool, every one of the small circles where I placed the camera in my model has a given number. And it's important to note that these numbers actually do not correspond with the numbers in Capture. These are two different numbers. The reason for that is because in Capture, you start at scan position one, but if scan position two is not aligned, the next scan position in the list is three. So you'll go from one to three and you'll skip two. In this case, number three is actually going to become two. So in Workshop, all your scan positions are renumbered from one and up. And in Capture, you might be missing some numbers either because they were deleted or didn't align. So now you have a really good idea on how to navigate this tool. You've got your numbered scans over here on the right, as well as the numbered scans on the floor where the camera was positioned. I can move to a scan position and the number is reflected up here. It tells me which number I'm currently on, as well as being highlighted over here on the right. You'll also notice that every scan position has this little view icon, this little eyeball icon that allows me to hide the scan from either this list view, or I can choose hide scan down here and that'll hide the current scan that I'm standing on. You can also see in the right-hand side that the scans included in my highlight reel are indicated with a small HLR icon right over here. Now, if I try to hide a scan that is currently being used in the highlight reel, I'll get this warning that tells me if I continue, my highlight from the highlight reel is going to be deleted. Now we'll get to the highlight reel in another video, but just so you understand, if that highlight was not captured using a snapshot, then that means it'll have to be recaptured. There's no way of bringing that back. So keep that in mind if you are going to hide a position that's currently being used in the highlight reel. I'll go ahead and cancel this for now, but you can see that if I hide scan number seven, notice the circle around scan number seven right here. As soon as I press hide, it becomes an X, which indicates to me that the scan position has been hidden. I can also see that the scan is grayed out over here and my icon has changed to a hidden icon. All of these indications give me a complete understanding of which scan positions are hidden and which are visible. Once I publish this, the hidden scans will not be accessible to my visitors. And the reason why I might want to hide a scan is because maybe that scan position was captured not for visitors to access. Maybe, for example, I'll go to my floor plan view here, and I'm gonna access scan number 110 right here. And you can see that this scan position is way, way, way in the corner of the room. And a lot of it, as I turn around, is really close to the wall and mostly curtains. So maybe this is not a really great scan position for my visitors to access, but it sure makes for a great scan position to use when capturing a snapshot of this room because it's so far back. So this is the scan position that I want to hide from my visitors. So I'll just go ahead and choose hide scan here. Now, if I've done a really good job scanning, I'm going to have a lot of scan positions all over the place. It's much easier to grab more scan positions than you actually need instead of coming back to the site to scan again. So I'll go to the floor plan view to get a good idea of the navigation path that a visitor can take going through this. And I can see that there's a lot of scan positions in this area over here. So I want to minimize that to make it a little bit easier for my visitors to navigate. So what I can do is just click on any one of these scan positions and just hit hide scan. And then I'll click over here and hit hide scan. So I can go through very quickly. Instead of navigating from one scan position to another, I can just go into the floor plan or dollhouse view, click on that scan position once to highlight it, and then choose hide scan. And that's basically it. I hope you found that information helpful, and we'll see you in the next video.